Hi, my name is Varsha Sujanani and I'm an Azure Technical Trainer with Microsoft. Today we're going to be talking about DP203, the Data Engineering course. I really like the course because it takes you through the journey of data movement. And we know organizations are not the same across the board. There are so many different types of industries. There are many different types of technologies as well. So it allows us to get an insight on how are we able to transform data with something like Databricks or working with Synapse Spark. And that's really why I like this course. This course, like I mentioned earlier, it takes you through the movement of data. How are we ingesting? Where are we storing this data? How are we transforming and prepping the data? Ultimately, where are we going to land and model and serve this data to where it's ready for reporting? As data engineers, we go through that movement of data. We are tapping into so many different types of technologies like Databricks or Synapse. But of course, as I've worked with so many organizations, we know that batch processing is all good, but we can't forget about that speed layer. And it's really cool to kind of see stream analytics in action or streaming with Databricks. And I think that's really awesome. I think it's really going to be exciting for you. I would definitely recommend at least having a fundamental knowledge across the data stack. There is a course called DP900, which is Data Fundamentals. I would also recommend at least having a fundamental knowledge across Azure. There's a course called AZ900, Azure Fundamentals, and I like to think of it as a mile long, inch deep into Azure. Coming into the course, you'll have the terminology needed and kind of a basic understanding across Azure and along with the data stack. There's also a virtual training day that I would recommend going through. It's Delivering Integrated Analytics with Azure Synapse. It'll help you come into the course with understanding the basic knowledge of how to work with Synapse. And then as you get into the course, we're going to get a lot hands-on, and we're also going to take a look at a couple of other technologies. So how can you prepare to take the exam after you go through the course? There's a couple of different places that I definitely recommend. Microsoft Learn, that's the one-stop shop of readiness, right? We have modules that take you through an intermediate to beginner and advanced data engineer. There's also practice tests that are given by Measure Up on behalf of Microsoft. Some of those questions are based off of those objective domains and get fairly granular to help you prepare with taking the exam. So what do you do after the course? That's really up to you. Where do you see your passion? Do you like working with relational databases? I would recommend going towards DP300. Or do you really see yourself at the production level, the production ready data? We have our data in a data warehouse. Now let's gain some insight with working with Power BI as a data analyst. I hope this was helpful and gave you some extra insight for the DP203 data engineer cert. Good luck on your journey and make sure you celebrate your accomplishments when you pass your exam on LinkedIn.